Hey guys, I'm back. Now, you might have been already shouting at me, but there is no Mankey here, only in the yellow version of the game. You can catch a Nidoran, both male and female, but yeah, it's only the yellow version. I think I've played the yellow version a little bit. And I think that's where I remember Mankey being part of this grass. Now, the problem is, why am I talking to this guy? I'm playing the blue version. I found the map. I'm gonna put it in the description down below so you can check it out as well. That's basically where you can pretty much find, well, it details pretty well which Pokémon to catch where in which version of the game. So that's pretty handy. And this guy had his coffee. Am I in a hurry? No. I see you're a Pokédex. When you catch a Pokémon, Pokédex is automatically updated. What? Don't you know how to catch a Pokémon? I'll show you how to then. I don't know if I talked to this guy ever. Might have. Well, it's a level 5 Weedle, that's amazing. Old man used Pokéball. So that's again Nintendo's holding your dick how to play this game. First you need to weaken the target Pokémon. Alright, gotcha. What if I tell him I have no time? I've had my coffee now and I feel great. Sure you can go through. Are you in a hurry? Yes. Time is money. Go along then. Great. And actually, if you're wondering, the Viridian City Gym, this Pokémon Gym is always closed. I wonder who the leader is. Well, it ties in with who the last badge gym leader is. Now, you'll be surprised. I think I have a vague memory on who that might be, but I don't wanna really spoil it for you guys who never completed this game but played it. The gym's doors are closed. Cause to be honest, I don't think that there is a person on earth who doesn't know what a Pokemon is. Or at least played the game or seen the anime, whatever. So I'm not sure where I left off. When I go shopping Pewter City, I have to take the winding trail in Viridian Forest. Well, that's where we're gonna go, and I think catch Pokemon and expand your collection. The more you have, the easier it is to fight. Yep, so I think I haven't gone up this far yet. And I think this is where I left off. Route 2, Viridian City, Pewter City. So we're gonna go to Pewter City now, because that's the first gym that we can actually fight. And because I have the water-type Pokémon Squirtle, it's gonna be a walk in the park, literally. I know I use walk in the park a lot, but this is going to be really like walk in the park. And those are items that you can collect, might contain TMs, A-Gems, or just Pokéballs or whatever, antidotes, items. Yo! Are you going to Viridian Forest? Be careful, it's a natural maze. Well, Rattata may be small, but its bite is wicked. Did you get one? No. Because Rattata is shit. Trainer tips again. Weaken Pokemon before attempting capture. When healthy, they may escape. Well, they may escape when they're weakened as well. I came here with some friends, they're out for Pokemon fights. Thanks for notifying. However, I checked the map that I'm going to leave in the description below because it's an amazing map. Kudos to the guy who made it. But here you can catch a Pikachu in blue and red. So I'm gonna attempt that. I'm gonna grind this baby out until I get a Pikachu. For poison, use antidote, get it at Pokemon Mart, or I think that item also has, I mean that Pokeball also has an antidote. It should have. Or maybe this one. Oh, I found the Pokeball. Great. I want a Pikachu. And probably a Weedle and a good Caterpie as well. Because they are easy to evolve. If you want to avoid battles, stay away from grassy areas. No, I want battles, actually. I ran out of Pokeballs to catch Pokemon with. You should carry extras. Oh, come on. Am I using Rapple? The heck? Don't wanna go there yet, because that guy's going to aggro, as far as I remember. But yeah, this is where I'm gonna catch a Pikachu, because if I don't catch a Pikachu here, I'm not gonna have an active Pokemon for a while. That's gonna suck. Oh, I didn't heal my Pokemon? Oh, I'm so bad. Anyways, I'm gonna catch this Caterpie because it's level 5 one. Good. Well, get in my belly. By the way, the reason why I'm playing even more Pokemon Blue nowadays is that because Pokemon Go had a new update which basically says my phone is not compatible with the game anymore. It is bullshit because it's Android 5.1 and that should be compatible. So until that's fixed or I'm getting a better phone, I'm gonna just stick to this Pokemon game. Caterpie, a worm, its short feet are tipped with suction pads that enable it to tirelessly climb slopes and walls. Do I want a nickname? No. Caterpie is fine. Now the problem is, I will have to go back, because I just realized I don't have my Pokemon up to par. So yeah, until they fix Pokemon Go, I'm gonna just basically come home from work and have some fun with this bad boy here. I think a level 5 Caterpie is pretty good to start out with. I don't think it's gonna do too much, but this is how it's gonna be. I'm gonna try to give this Caterpie as much experience as possible. I don't really care about Spearow much, Nidoran same, but Caterpie is actually pretty good to have in the beginning. I'm gonna put Caterpie as the first Pokemon and pretty much just rearrange. Beam. Great. Let's see if I can buy or sell something at the mart. I don't think that this guy still has anything useful for me. I don't really need too many Pokeballs, because to be honest, I want to catch a Weedle, a Pikachu, maybe a male Nidoran. That's already 4 Pokemon, and there are no other Pokemon I want to catch. Maybe a Rattata and a Pidgey. If I get a higher level one, like at least level 5 or 6, would be nice. I don't want to catch a level 2 Pidgey and then I'm not going to be able to do anything with it. But a level 5 Caterpie is already something nice. Now give me that Pikachu. Give me a Pikachu. Level 3 Weedle. No, you can go to hell. Right, tackle. Now this is what I'm gonna do. Please don't get poisoned. Really. Fight with him, then switch him over with... Squirtle? No, Squirtle is fine. I'm gonna try to do it like this, because I know that Spearow's attack is pretty good against Weedle. then they can share the experience. Boom. Are you like me? Well, it's not much of an experience, but still, I mean, it's going to be a slow crawl. But I do want my Caterpie to be evolved to a Metapod. They evolve to Metapod at level 7, same as Weedle evolves to Kakuna at level 7. And then I think level 13, or maybe less, they evolve to their final form. And at least Caterpie is a pretty good Pokemon to have. Butterfree, I think is the final version. It's gonna take some grinding to get that Pikachu. Obviously the least percentage of chance you have is to catch a Pikachu. Metapod. Okay. Well, what you can do here is grind it out. But this guy is just gonna use Harden. And it's gonna be harder and harder to actually deal damage. But it's possible. Yeah, this is a really good place to level up some low-level Pokemon, because all you gotta do is just attack them if you have the time and the nerve. I mean, you still do quite a lot of damage. I mean, this takes from RPG rules that it doesn't matter how much difference is between the attack and the defense, and obviously the defense is higher than the attacker's attack. You still deal one damage, and there's still a chance for critical hit. What? 51 experience wasn't enough for Caterpie to go up one level. Oh my god. I really wanna catch the Pikachu and then go fighting. Then go battling. I may even try to catch the Pikachu without weakening it too much, because I really wanna use him right away. I don't wanna go back to town. This is a nuisance. Where is this Pikachu hiding? Well, I wish I could have gotten a Mankey, but if I remember correctly, what I read is that Pokemon Yellow follows the anime better. Which means the Pokemon that Ash meets are basically the Pokemon that are in Yellow. That's why the whole pacing of the game is different. Ooh. It failed. Well, too bad for you. This is a good. Yeah, this is good. I want to level up Spearow a bit, and I also want to level up my Caterpie, so they are a good combo. So yeah, Yellow is more closer to the anime. That's why you can get a Mankey quite early in the game, because I remember Ash meeting a Mankey quite early. But Pokemon Red and Blue are obviously different completely. Kakuna. Nah, I'm just gonna tackle this bitch until it dies. That's basically Weedle. Ooh, wow, critical hit, nice. Well, basically after the Caterpie evolves into its next form. Sorry guys, I'm a bit tired. I can't remember names that I've just seen a couple of minutes ago. Yeah, but after that he will only be able to use Harden. And then you can't solo anything with him. You have to be part of a fight. with him. Level 6, yay! Now give me that Pikachu. I've double checked it. You can get a Pikachu in Pokémon Red and Blue in this area. It might be a bit later. And, well, the chances are quite low. Let's see. Shift. Yeah, good. I wonder what happens if I sneak past him. Again, Metapod. It's gonna harden all day. If you know what I mean. So yeah, I'm a bit disappointed about Pokémon Go itself. I mean, I think it's a nice time to talk about the game itself. I think it's a good new concept, but the development is just horrendously bad. I mean, I've been working in different development projects and stuff, and I've even helped guys develop their own game. Like social network game is the right description to give it. Oh, no more PP! Oh, well, fuck. Well, that's bad. I will have to switch this guy now. Oh, well. And, I mean, how hard it is to make a game consistently performing, like, it had so many bugs. It really became quite... Wait, what? I think both of them got experience. I hope so. Yeah, but Caterpie doesn't have any more PPs. Oh well. So I can sneak past that guy, that's good. So this Pikachu might be deeper in the forest. Yeah, what I wanted to say is that it's, Pokémon Go, good concept, okay game, but all in all, I'm not impressed, and the late game is just so boring. Like, I mean, level 21 and you have to gather 75,000 experience. I mean, dude, like, I mean, I live in a big city, but for those guys who don't, that must be horrendously frustrating. And I've been to the countryside with Pokémon Go. There are absolutely no stops, like zero stops along the way. Like, it's on another level of stupid. How scarce Pokémon stops, not to mention gyms, are outside the cities. Plus, it's really all about cheaters. Like, I've seen Pokémon that are like, guys, it's either you've been playing from day one, all day, all night, or you beat Los Angeles for the weekend. And I don't mean actually physically been there. I mean, I have a couple of friends who play the hacked version. I've seen what they can do. I mean, they bought home their accounts. They did. I mean, Niantic did pretty much ban a lot of these hacked hacker accounts, but still there's a lot left. Like, I mean, come on, how the fuck do you have 3,000 CP Dragonite? I could only catch a Dratini in 2 months I've been playing that game. Only a freaking Dratini. I mean, that's disgusting. And I haven't been farming each and every day, but come on. How much do you have to farm with that game? Like, I know the game should be hard, or at least challenging, but the way they designed it is all about... Okay, this game is free. You guys want some help? Well, you can buy it for $100. You can buy these coins, which you can only get like 21 hours. Every 21 hours, and obviously the more Pokemon you have in the gyms, the better, and the higher level Pokemon you have, so it's basically, it really favors the cheaters and those who have been playing this game since day one and who play this game all day and all night. And let's be honest, nobody has time for that shit. And Caterpie's gonna evolve now. Yay. But yeah, I don't want to slack off Pokemon Go because it's a good concept, it's just developers didn't do the right job. And are not doing the right job, even still. Now, I wonder if the PP was reset. How can I check? Aha! No. Oh, it can still use Tackle. That's interesting. Alright, well... Fuck, that's not what I wanted to do. Well, we have to do this again. I forgot that if I'm not hugging the wall there, then this guy is gonna fight me, and I don't want to fight that guy yet. Although I might need to be honest. I can't find a Pikachu here, then I'm gonna be a really sad panda. I mean, the best thing here is to catch a Caterpie, and then you get to keep all your skills as a Caterpie when you evolve to Metapod. As you could see, I could still use Tackle, but if you catch a Metapod, yeah, well, you have an evolved Pokemon, but what the heck are you going to do? It can only harden. So I forgot about that concept. But that's cool. So no Pikachu yet, but I also remember that you could catch a Pikachu here, but well, only every 1,000 years. I'm still gonna try to force myself to catch a Pikachu here, because that's just so OP to have an electric Pokemon at this point of the game. Obviously I'm gonna give it up if it really gets annoying to search for one. Like now, actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and... and just continue on. Just fight those trainers and see where we get. So I do need to level up my Squirtle. Yeah, it's all about the Squirtle. Alright, bitch, it's time to fight. Hey, you have Pokemon, come on, let's battle them. Come on, bro. What you got? A Weedle. Well, why am I not surprised? Well, that wasn't too effective. I think Tackle works better against Bug Pokemon. Whoa! Yeah, because, well, I guess Bubble is a water move. Water moves aren't that effective against Grass, Bug, and Poison, maybe? Not even sure. But Grass and Bug, definitely. Yay! Oh, again, why am I using Bubble? Well, it's actually not too bad. Yay. Give me your money. No, KW can't cut it. $60. Shh, you scared the bugs away. Well, shh, you, bitch. You've been shouting that you wanna fight me and stuff. Right, so this guy's gonna try to fight me as well. Yo, you can gem out if you're a Pokémon trainer. Whatever that means, dude. Let me guess. You have a Caterpie? Or a Weedle? Weedle to start. Well, that's impressive. You actually hindered your Weedle to evolve. You deserve to die. What's good against bug Pokémon? Oh, I know! I think normal Pokémon, or flying actually. But I really want to level up my Squirtle more, because Pewter Gym is going to be easy, but I still need Squirtle to be at least half decent. And I don't really wanna waste too much experience on my other Pokémon. If I had a Pikachu, that would be different. I would be switching. But actually, Electric is pretty good against bugs as well, now that I think about it. Ooh, nice critical hit. Electric is pretty much good against everything. Well, not really against rock Pokemon, as far as I'm concerned. That was covered in the anime as well. Pikachu had a hard time against Onix. Another Weedle, great. Ah, I missed. Please don't poison me, bro. Poison is nasty. Huh? I ran out of Pokemon. And money as well. Darn, I'm going to catch some stronger ones. Contact Professor Oak via PC to get your Pokédex evaluated. For which you won't get any money nor experience. Come on, you Pikachu, you. Pika bitch. Hello. I found an antidote. Great. As far as I'm concerned. Yeah, that's the wrong way. Cool. I like the encounter rates. Oh, come on. switch my Pokémon. I want some experience for my Metapod. I want it to hatch. Yay. I'm never gonna get a Pikachu. But I swear to God, it's on that map. And it says blue and red, but not in yellow. Which makes sense, because the anime didn't feature Pikachu catchable, at least not as far as I'm concerned. I mean, Ash got the Pikachu right from the start. Just the same as you would get Pikachu if you played Pokémon Yellow. Which did make me a little bit contemplate the fact that there are three teams in Pokémon Go, right? Why didn't they actually make four teams? Because historically there's Pokémon Blue, Red, Green, and then Yellow. So it would make sense to have four teams. But now, as it is, you have two competing teams and you have the best team in the world, Instinct, who don't give a shit. There should be a green team as well, because four teams are more fun than three. It wouldn't have been a big development cost for them to do a green team. No stealing of Pokemon from other trainers, catch only wild Pokemon. Well, that is the Team Rocket. That guy's gonna fight me. Come on, give me my Pikachu. That's pretty much the last guy to fight, right? Yeah, looks like. Come on, I'm not asking for a Snorlax or something. Just give me a Pikachu. Come on now. Well, this must be very interesting to watch. Oh my god, seriously. Maybe I'm gonna do these things off screen. Because, I mean, off recording, because it doesn't really work for me to just go around like an idiot trying to find Pokemon that I'm not gonna catch, and I have like maybe a 1% chance to actually catch them ever. Even if I have like some chance, it might be just RNGesus effing me in the ass. But I don't really want to play this game off recording, because it takes away all the fun. But then I don't want to post it either. Oh, if this is not Pikachu, then I'm gonna cut. Oh, fuck me, Weedle. A level 3 Weedle as is. Not even a good one. Go, Metapod! Kill this poor Pokemon. Getting through this forest is already pretty stupid. I mean, Pokemon was always about grinding, but I will try not to level grind. I will try to grind for some Pokemon, but not level grind. I found level grinding stupid. Well, I'm just gonna fight this guy now. Hey, wait up, what's the hurry? One Pokemon, eh? Beefy Weedle. Well, that's great. Of course I got poisoned. That's great. Oh, well, that is amazing. Ready? Whoa! Actually killed my Metapod. Well, you little bitch. That Squirtle will take all the glory. Little bitch. I give you... You're good at this. I give it to you, you're good at this. I think that's what he was trying to say. 90 bucks. Sometimes you can find stuff on the ground. I'm looking for the stuff I dropped. Well, good on you, I found them. Well, even though if you get poisoned, it doesn't matter because you're not going to black out because you have Pokemon who are not poisoned. So it's better to wait to just go to the Poké Center and heal them up. Even though I still want to stay for Pikachu. This is the point where I'm not going to really care much about this Pokemon at all. Actually, I'm never gonna use antidote, so why not? You know what? No. Fuck it. Squirtle can go to hell. I have other Pokemon to fight with. Sell that. I don't really need Squirtle at this point. I don't even want to fight. Come on, give me a Pikachu. Squirtle fainted. Well, hallelujah, finally. That was getting annoying. Okay, I give it one more chance. If it doesn't work, then I'm just gonna end recording and start recording once I'm actually fighting a Pikachu. So that's the only way I can do this. Level 3 Weedle. Doesn't even worth my time. Yay. Well guys, I'll be back once I find the Pikachu. Peace. Well, looky what I've got here. A Pikachu. Pretty fat one at that. It didn't take me much. Technically it was 2 or 3 tries more. So, well, I don't wanna fuck this up. Let's pack this Pikachu a bit. Alright, it's not too effective. Woo! Whoa! Little fucker. Okay. Nope. Item. Catch that Pika bitch. Level 3 Pikachu, but I don't really have any room to complain. Still a Pikachu. A mouse? I thought it was a squirrel. When several of these Pokemon gather, the electricity could build and cause lightning storms. No. Well, that's great. I will have to do some editing. Yay! Leaving Viridian Forest, Pewter City ahead. Actually, this is what I'm gonna do. Have you noticed the bushes on the roadside? They can be cut down by a special Pokemon move called Cut. Many Pokemon live only in forests and caves. You need to look everywhere to get different kinds. Yeah, well, that's again another hint to learning cut. Can I get a Nidoran? I don't even think... Well, yeah, let's pack this guy. Yay. I don't think there's anything special here, to be honest. Any Pokémon that takes part in battle, however short, earns XP. True that. Psst, do you know what I'm doing? No. I'm spraying Rappel to keep Pokémon out of my garden. Yes, that's right, it's hard work. Amazing. Pewter City, a stone gray city. But why would you spray Rappel to keep Pokémon away? I mean, I know the use of Rappel, but otherwise, why would you do that? Notice, the thieves have been stealing Pokémon fossils at Mount Moon. Please call Pewter Police with any info. Your trainer, right? Brock's looking for new challenges. Follow me. Oh, dude. Seriously? That's how you're gonna do me now? Great. If you have the right stuff, go take on Brock. Well, no, really. I just arrived. Pewter City Pokemon Gym leader Brock. The rock solid Pokemon trainer. If you know what I mean. Gay! It's rumored that Clefairies came from the moon. They appeared after Moonstone fell on Mount Moon. I think Moonstone is the only way to evolve a Clefairy, or Clefairy, whatever. I'm not even sure about half of the pronunciation of this Pokemon, because I used to watch the original series in German, and the original German dub made a new name for most of the Pokemon. Like, Meowth was Mousy. Well, Pikachu was Pikachu, but there was some other Pokemon which I can't recall. Anyways, Pewter Museum of Science. Alright. It's 50 Poké Dollars for a child's ticket. Would you like to come in? Well, if you consider me as a child, yes, right, 50. Thank you. Well, take plenty of time to look. Well, dude, I just paid you $50. There's no way I'm gonna go out with a bang. Without a bang. That is one magnificent fossil. Ah, it's an Aerodactyl fossil, a primitive and rare Pokemon. Kabutops? Yeah, Kabutops. Fossil, a primitive and rare Pokemon. Great. We have a space exhibit now. Meteorite that fell on Mount Moon. Moonstone? July 20th, 1969. The first lunar landing. I bought a color TV to watch it. Moonstone? What's so special about it? Well, it's in capital letters, just like all other items, so I guess you can obtain one. Hopefully. Space Shuttle Columbia. Whoa! I want a Pikachu, it's so cute. I asked my daddy to catch me one. Yeah, Pikachu soon, I promise. Well, I have a Pikachu, but it took me a lot of grinding. But not too much, I was actually lucky. I want my 50 bucks back. Can't go out the back yet. But I guess there's more stuff to get in there once I learn cut. Cut is such an essential skill. What? Nidoran, sit! Bow Bow. Amazing. Our Pokemon's an insider, so it's hard to handle. Insider is a Pokemon that you get in a trade. It grows fast, but it may ignore an unskilled trainer in battle. If only we had some badges. I see. Through a trade. Well, that's not gonna really menace me at all, because I do not have the option of trading. But thanks on the tip. Did you check out the museum? Yes, unfortunately. Weren't those fossils from Mount Moon amazing? Not for $50, to be honest. Really? You absolutely have to go. No. Oh, fuck me. Really? All these errand boys. Thanks. It's right here. You have to pay to get in, but it's worth it. It's worth it. See you around. Yeah, walk off screen while I'm frozen. Great programming. And now you're back there again. All your item needs fulfilled. Pokemon Mart. Good things can happen if you raise Pokemon diligently, even the weak ones. A shady old man got me to buy this really weird fish Pokemon. It's totally weak and it costs 500 Poké Dollars. Can I buy it from you? I guess it's a Magikarp. Probably a Magikarp. Hi there, may I help you? Yeah, buy. I can buy some potions. Oh. I'm sorry. Well, escape rope is pretty good because that takes you out of a dungeon. If I remember correctly, so that can be useful. Otherwise, not really. Awakening, Paralyze Heal, Burn Heal. Not really interested. I'd rather buy some potions, because those are always good. And that's all my money gone. Unless I sell one antidote. Keep one Pokemon alive, that's all I need. Right. There aren't any serious Pokemon trainers here. They're all like bug catchers, but Pewter James Brock is totally into it. Into what? Heal your Pokemon for free. Actually need to do that. Oh, when Jigglypuff sings, Pokemon get drowsy. Me too. Snore. Wow. 8-bit sounds. What's better than that? Nothing. I have 5 Pokemon. Wow. What? Team Rocket is at Mount Moon, huh? I'm on the phone. Scram. Great. Pokemon become easier to catch when they are hurt or asleep, but it's not a sure thing. Pokemon learn new techniques as they grow, but some moves must be taught by the trainer. Great. With TMs and HMs, where TMs can be used only once, but HMs can be used a couple of times. Right, let's see the gym then. It's rumored that Clay Fairy came from the moon. Okay. Looks like I can't go. Where's my map? What? Wait, whoa. Did I forget to pick up the map? Really? Oh my god. I shouldn't play games when I'm tired. Oh well. That's gonna bite me in the ass later. Hiya, I can tell you have what it takes to become a Pokémon champ. I'm no trainer, but I can tell you how to win. Let me take you to the top. Alright, let's get happening. The first Pokémon out in a match is at the top of the Pokémon list. By changing the order of Pokémon, matches could be made easier. Nope. It's a free service. Let's tap it. Oh my god. Thanks. Pewter City Pokémon Gym Leader Brock, winning trainers Prick. Well, of course he's one step in front of me all the time. Right. I think it's just gonna be Squirtle. Maybe Pikachu. To have Pikachu some experience. I think she's gonna be wrecked to death. Pikachu's gonna have a bad time, but I will try to keep an eye out for her or him. Now, you can skip this trainer if you want and go straight to Brook, but it's a good thing to fight this guy, actually. Stop right there, kid. You're still light years from facing Brook. Light years, eh? Nice phrase. Junior trainer. A Diglett. Well, that's interesting. I'm afraid that Pikachu is gonna get wrecked to death, so I'm gonna switch right away. Scratch. Well, that might have killed Pikachu. Well, that's a ground Pokémon, so technically water moves should be effective. Ho ho! I wonder where you got that Diglett. Switch back to Pikachu real quick and pray to the gods that... Oh, wow. Alright, Pikachu came out to get slapped in the face. Oh, for fuck's sake, really? Oh, that's not nice. Oh. That's all the way bad. This is going down south already. Oops. Nope. And his speed fell. So sometimes bubble causes them to lose some speed, that's good. Ah, fuck's sake. Ah. This accuracy swing is really killing me. Level 6? Dude. Darn, light years isn't time. It measures distance. You're pretty hot, but not as hot as Brock. Okay. Now I'm gonna go back, heal up my Pokémon. And start a new day. Where's this the mod? Where's the center? It was supposed to be here. Quite convenient. Heal my Pokémon, thank you. Now it's time to solo this bitch. Good thing that you don't have to fight this again, you just have to win against them once. Now it's Brock time. I'm Brock, I'm Pewter's gym leader. I believe in rock hard defenses and determination. That's why my Pokémon are all the rock type. You still want to challenge me? Fine then, show me your best. Well bro, you'll be surprised. Hey dude. Well, Pikachu ain't gonna do shit. Defense curl. Oh, that's cute. Woohoo! Oh, an Onix. Well, hopefully, the Onix won't bit slap Pikachu too much. Bide. Great. Well, that's an amazing move, but that's enough, Pikachu. Now, Bide is all about the Onix, for example, this time Onix taking damage, and then after 2 or 3 rounds the damage is even after 1 round, it seems like if you don't attack him then it has no effect, but if you attack him he'll reflect the damage twice. He'll reflect twice the damage that you deal to him during this couple of rounds until Bide vanishes. So it's quite a good one, but as you can see, you just have to ignore him until Bide wears off. And Brock is dead, because water Pokémon kill rock Pokémon. I took you for granted. As proof of your victory, here's the Boulder Badge. Yay! That's an official Pokémon League badge. Its bearers' Pokémon become more powerful. The technique Flash can now be used anytime. If I got Flash. Wait, take this with you. TM34. The TM contains a technique that can be taught to Pokémon. The TM is good only once, so when you use one to teach a new technique, pick the Pokémon carefully. TM34 contains Bide, the same that I just explained, that Onix used. Your Pokémon will absorb damage in battle, then pay it back double. There are all kinds of trainers in the world. You appear to be very gifted as a Pokémon trainer. Go to the gym in Cerulean and test your abilities. Well, I guess that's the one with Misty, the water-type Pokémon, and I already have a Pikachu, which I'm gonna abuse against the water-type Pokémon. That's going to be in Cerulean Gym. Well, that was amazing. And I think I will leave it at that. Because that should be a good episode. So now I'm gonna just try to get Pikachu and Squirtle up to par. Squirtle should evolve soon. I don't know about Pikachu. To be honest, I don't mind it becoming a Raichu. I need a good electric Pokemon, a good water Pokemon, I need a good fire Pokemon. Basically, that's almost all the well, there are more elements in this game, but the three major elements. And then I would need a good grass Pokemon as well. And a good psychic one. Probably an Abra would be nice. We'll see. Or a Drowsy. Thanks for watching, guys, and peace out.